Welcome to our worship service for January the 17th, 2021. We welcome you all to our worship service today and pray that we will be blessed by being together even though we are apart. And now let us prepare our hearts to worship God. Let us pray together the call to worship. Come and see the grace of God.
Christ, our teacher and our friend.
Come and see the Son of God.
Christ, our healer and salvation.
God is moving in this place.
Come and see. Come and see.
And let us pray the prayer of invocation together. Eternal God, your Son, Jesus Christ, now exalted as Lord of all, pours out his gifts on the church. Grant us that unity which your Spirit gives. Keep us in the bond of peace, and bring all creation to worship before your throne. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen. Our opening hymn is I, the Lord of Sea and Sky.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright, who will bear my light to them, whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord, is it I, Lord? I have heard you the Lord of wind and flame. I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my hand.
Let us join together in the prayer of confession. God of abundant mercy, you embodied love for us in the life of Jesus Christ. You ate with sinners and shared with outcasts. You loved with boldness and healed with grace. Forgive us, O God, when we do not trust your love, when we doubt whether we are worthy of your care. Forgive us, O God, when we try to cheapen love, when we limit it to shallow feelings instead of bold actions. Help us, O God, when we cannot feel your love, when we are isolated, afraid, and unable to see your presence. Forgive us, O God, of all the ways we fall short. Free us to try again, and let your love lead the way. And let us pray our own silent confession. The mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting. I declare to you in the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. May the God of mercy, who forgives you all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now let us say with meaning in our hearts our profession of faith, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence she shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Prepare our hearts, O God, to accept your word. Silence in us any voice but your own, that hearing we may also obey your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our scripture for today is from the Old Testament, from 1 Samuel chapter 3, verses 1 through 10 and verse 19. Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. the lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." And he said, "Here I am," and ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call, lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call, my son, lie down again." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again a third time, and he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, "Go, lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." As Samuel grew up, the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The title of the sermon this morning is "The Sacred Power of a Listening Heart." Over 80 years ago, Jed Harris was a successful producer of plays. And one of his successful works was the production of Thornton Wilder's play, Our Town. In the middle of a lengthy season mixed with the intense pressure of many details, Harris began to lose his sense of hearing. He couldn't even hear what other people close to him were saying, and so he was missing crucial details during conversations. As a result, Jed Harris decided to pay a visit to a renowned audiologist who listened attentively as the producer narrated the sad account of his declining ability to hear. After a thorough examination of Harris's ears, the hearing specialist drew out from his vest an expensive gold-coated pocket watch and placed it against the producer's ear. "Do you hear this watch ticking?" the audiologist asked. "Absolutely," the producer responded. The audiologist moved further away and held up the watch to his office door. Harris focused and remarked, "Yes, it is quite audible." The physician then walked into the next room and asked, "How about now?" "It's still audible," Harris said. The specialist stalked back into the office, returned his watch to his vest. "This phenomenon is quite commonplace," he said, "especially among successful individuals. Your hearing is excellent, Mr. Harris. You've simply quit listening." Well, do you know anyone like that? They don't have a hearing problem, but they most certainly do have a listening problem. Obviously, some people do have hearing problems. That happens, of course, especially later in life. Hearing aids are part of that. But not nearly as often as people missing messages simply because they do not listen to one another. Robert Holden, in his book Happiness Now, tells about a husband and wife, both in their late 70s, who decided after 55 years of marriage to get a divorce. When their counselor asked them why, the wife issued a catalog of reasons. "He never asks if I am happy," said the wife. "I assumed you were," said the husband. "He never says he loves me," said the wife. "I thought you knew I loved you." The wife continued, "He never says I'm beautiful." The husband replied, "I look at you every day and admire your beauty." "We rarely talk," said the wife. "I know you like to read a lot," said the husband. "I read because we don't talk," said the wife. There was a pause. "And we never go out," said the wife. "I thought you liked to stay in," said the husband. "I only stay in because I'm waiting to go out," said the wife. The counselor continued to take notes. "He's also very mean to me," said the wife. "In what way?" asked the counselor. "Well, at breakfast, 3 times a week, for 55 years, he always serves me the crust of the loaf, and I hate the bread crust." The husband was distraught. I give you the crust, my dear, because that is my favorite part of the loaf. What we have here, says the familiar movie line, is a failure to communicate. Communication is so vital to successful living. Women seem to be more conscious of that than men. One national magazine polled over 30,000 women, and only one problem ranked above conflict over money: poor communication. Researcher Terry Schultz writes, although many women chose their partners based on sex appeal, research shows that if they had to do it over again, they said the ability to communicate is much more important. There's a beautiful story in the Bible about someone who spent a lifetime listening. In his case, though, he was listening to God. Most of you remember the story of the boy Samuel from your Sunday school days. It begins with the very touching scene of a holy woman named Hannah pleading with God to allow her to bear a son because she's barren. Hannah made a vow to God that if he would allow her to bear a son, she would give the boy to the service of God all the days of his life. Some time passed, and God answered Hannah's prayer. She conceived and bore a son, calling his name Samuel, saying, "Because I have asked for him from the Lord." Well, some time passed, and God answered Hannah's prayer. She conceived and bore a son, naming him Samuel, saying, "Because I have asked for him from the Lord." Hannah followed through on her promise to give Samuel to God. As soon as he was weaned, Samuel was placed under the care and training of an old priest named Eli. Eli was gradually losing his vision, but he was faithful in his teaching of young Samuel. He also gave Samuel light duties about the tabernacle. One night, when Samuel was about 11 years old, he had a life-changing experience. He was lying down there in the house of the Lord trying to go to sleep when he heard a voice in the night. He ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." But Eli said, "I did not call. Go back and lie down." So he went and lay down. Again, the voice called, "Samuel." And once again, Samuel got up to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "My son," said Eli, "I did not call. Go back and lie down." Now Samuel had been studying about God, the record indicates, but he did not yet know God. The word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. That's interesting, don't you think? Could there be many people, including many people in church, who have studied about God, but do not know God? I wonder. Maybe it's because we haven't been listening for God's voice. A third time in the night, the voice called, "Samuel." And Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." Then, says the scripture, Eli realized that the Lord was calling the boy. So Eli told Samuel, "Go and lie down. And if he calls you, say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went down and lay in his place. The Lord came and stood there, calling as at the other times, "Samuel, Samuel." Then Samuel said, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." It's a beautiful story about the call of one of Israel's great prophets. God spoke, Samuel listened. The 19th verse of this chapter says, "The Lord was with Samuel as he grew up, and he let none of Samuel's words fall to the ground." In other words, Samuel, who listened to God, had a lifelong relationship with God and a fruitful ministry. Today, we want to spend just a few moments dealing with the sacred power of a listening heart. Wonderful things happen sometimes when we're willing to listen. The first thing we need to note is that listening is not the same thing as hearing. Hearing refers to the sound that enters your ears. It's a physical process that, provided you don't have any hearing problems, happens automatically. Listening, however, requires more than that. It requires focus and concentrated effort. An 80-year-old grandfather went to his daughter's house for Sunday dinner, and when the meal was over, he announced that he was going to take a walk through the town in the neighborhood. "I'll be back in 20 minutes," he said. But 2 hours had passed before he finally returned. "I'm sorry I'm late," he said, "but I stopped to talk to an old friend and he just wouldn't stop listening." Well, I like that. Some people will not stop talking, but blessed is the person who will not stop listening. That's a wonderful gift to give to someone, to listen to them that intently. The greatest honor you can pay someone is to really listen to them. As David Ogilvie once said, an open ear is the only believable sign of an open heart. And I remember one confirmation class I had in Nicholson, we were talking about the gifts of the Spirit. And I said to the young people, "Do you know what your gift of the Spirit is?" And some of them really didn't know. That's a hard question to ask. But one girl said to me, "I know what your gift of the Spirit is, Pastor." And I thought, "Oh, what do I do now?" So I said, "Okay." I said, "What do you think my gift of the Spirit is?" She said, "You're a good listener." And that has stayed with me for a long time. I so cherish that statement from her. But it's not, listening is not the same as hearing. Listening requires intent. It requires focus. One common problem, instead of listening closely to what someone is saying, that we're often get distracted after a sentence or two, and instead we start to think about what we're going to say in reply to what the person is telling us. This means that we don't listen to the rest of what the other person is saying. You can see how treacherous that can be. Listening is so important that many top employers provide listening skill training for their employees. This is not surprising when you consider that good listening skills can lead to better customer relations and customer satisfaction, greater productivity with fewer mistakes, and an increased sharing of information. That, in turn, can lead to a more creative and innovative workplace. But I think we can all agree, hearing is not the same as listening. Listening to someone is a way of saying, "You are important to me. You matter." Author and radio teacher Chuck Swindoll once found himself with too many commitments in too few days. In his book, Stress Fractures, he tells about getting nervous and tense about it. "I was snapping at my wife and our children, choking down my food at mealtimes, and feeling irritated at those unexpected interruptions through the day. Before long, things around our house started reflecting the pattern of my hurry-up style. It was actually becoming unbearable. I distinctly remember one night after supper, the words of our younger daughter, Colleen. She wanted to tell me something important that had happened to her in school that day. And she began hurriedly, 'Daddy, I want to tell you something, and I'll tell you really fast.' Suddenly, realizing her frustration, Swindoll answered, 'Honey, you can tell me, and you don't have to tell me really fast. Say it slowly.' I'll never forget her answer," he said. She said, "Then listen slowly." What she wanted to know was if her daddy cared enough about her to really listen to her. That's what many people hunger for. When we listen to them, really listen, we're saying to them, "You matter to me, you're important to me." Of course, the most important listening we can do is to listen to God. It's interesting how much time Jesus spent in prayer. Obviously, he believed listening to the voice of God was important. It's God's deepest wish to direct his children toward positive, fulfilling lives. But most of us never listen, and so we miss out on some of life's greatest joys. Nancy Ortberg tells of going out to dinner with a man named Doug Cole in Washington, D.C. years ago. Doug told her about a 30-year-old insurance executive he met at a party. Doug learned that this young man, Bob, was a new Christian. Intrigued, he asked how things were going. "Have you found a church?" he asked. "Yes," Bob said. "Have you found a Bible study?" "Yes, I have one of those too." Finally, Doug asked, "How about your relationship with God and prayer?" Well, Bob didn't have much going on there and said that he didn't know much about that. So Doug laid out a challenge for him to pick something to pray for every day for the next 6 months. The prayers could be elaborate or simple, structured or free form, listening to or speaking to God, whatever. But Bob must pray at least briefly every day. If at the end of 6 months, God has not done something truly significant, Doug told him, "I will then pay you $500. Nancy told Doug, "That doesn't sound very biblical." "No, but I do it all the time," Doug answered her. Well, Bob accepted the challenge, but didn't know what to pray for. Bob and his wife lived in D.C., and what with the city's international flavor, they chose a different land to pray for every day. So along those lines, Bob decided to pray daily for Kenya. Not much happened for 4 or 5 months. The prayer experiment was yielding little. Then one night, he sat next to a woman at a dinner party, and guess what? She was from Kenya. She ran an orphanage, and Bob related that he felt as though ice water was suddenly running through his veins. He had been fantasizing about how to spend the $500 Doug had promised him. But suddenly, he had an image of a wad of $500 sprouting wings and flying away. He asked for details about the orphanage and listened to her answers for a full, intense hour. She told Bob that no one had ever shown such interest before. Would he consider flying to Kenya to see it firsthand? To make a long story short, Bob ended up providing for the care of those Kenyan children and seeing to the supplying of the orphanage. He made such a splash that the president of Kenya invited him to the palace. There, Bob advocated for prisoners of conscience in that country, and later, those prisoners were released. The U.S. Secretary of State called Bob and asked him how he did it. The United States government had been unsuccessfully seeking their freedom for some time. It was no mystery to Bob to how it came about. God had guided him to pray for Kenya, and wonderful things were happening. If you and I were truly listening to God, we would see wonderful things happen in our lives too. Hearing is not the same as listening. When we listen to someone, we're saying, "You're really important to me. You matter." The most important listening we can do is to listen to God. To God's deepest wish is to direct us to a positive and fulfilling life. If that's not happening in our lives, it's because we're not listening to Him. Remember what St. Paul said, "Faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ." Notice he did not say that faith comes from talking or from doing. Faith comes from hearing, and that only happens when we listen. The old prophet Eli told young Samuel, "Go and lie down, and if he calls you, say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord came and stood there, calling as at the other times, "Samuel, Samuel." Then Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." What an eloquent yet powerful prayer. Are you listening to the people around you, especially those closest to you? More importantly, are you listening to God? Am I listening to God? A positive, fulfilling life awaits us. Just listen. Amen. the joys and concerns. We have no joys this week that we know of. The concerns are those that have appeared in your worship folder for the last couple of weeks. So if you still have those, please remember those friends and members of our church who are in special need. And now let us look to the Lord in prayer. Let us pray. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence with us. And Lord, we pray that you, as we go through these next days and weeks, that we will be listening to you and talking to you and listening to others instead of wanting our voice heard first. Lord, help us to listen to you more and to talk about ourselves less. Lord, we pray for those of our church membership and those friends who are in special need. Lord, you know each one and what they are dealing with. And so, Lord, in faith, we ask that you would help them get through the difficult times that they are facing. Lord, we pray for our nation at this critical moment in its history. Lord, we're not sure just exactly what is happening, but for Lord, we pray and we know that you are in control and that your will be done, whatever that may be. Help us, Lord, to accept that. Help us to have peace across our nation, that factions will just lay down their arms and their differences from each other, that we would practice love instead of hate, that we would think of you as we're perhaps saying things that we shouldn't say, doing things that we shouldn't do. Lord, we pray for those who are facing difficulties in their home life, in their family life, in their personal life, perhaps money issues, perhaps relationship issues. Lord, you are the answer to our problems if we would just have the faith to come to you and lay them at your feet, knowing that you love us and you want what is best for us. Father, we pray as always for our missionaries and our military personnel. Lord, they are doing so much for your work in difficult places. And so we pray for their safety. Father, we have each come with our own personal issues that are affecting our lives. And so we come to you in these moments of silent prayer. And now, Lord, we pray the prayer that you taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As always, we thank you for your support of this church and its mission. You may mail your offerings into the church or drop them off in the mailbox at the front door, and may you be blessed in your continued giving. Thank you. Lord, for the ways in which you have blessed us this past week, and thank you for the opportunity and the privilege of returning some of those gifts to you for the use of this church to forward your mission in this community. Direct us, Lord, in the ways that we should be doing this, and we will give you the praise and the thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Our closing hymn is, O Jesus, I Have Promised.
Jesus, I have promised to serve thee to the end. Be thou forever near me, my master and my friend. I shall not fear the battle if thou art by my side. No wander from the pathway if thou wilt be my guide. O Jesus, I thus promised to all who follow thee that thy servant be. And Jesus, I have promised to serve thee to the end. Oh, give me grace to follow my master and my friend.
Now receive the benediction. Whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God through him. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit remain with you always. Amen.